Hello guys, I'm back again. I made another tool. I finished the CSGO translator just a couple of seconds ago and just want to show you how to use it. There's a little description, so you have to add this to your launch options. I can do this at first. Just go to library, Counter-Strike Global Offensive, go to properties, and just add this to all your other launch options. Maybe this is empty for you, who knows, but for me there's some stuff inside. Just add this at the end and we are done. Okay, don't start the game at this moment. We are downloading the zip file, saving the zip, and yeah, I tested it before obviously, and if the download is ready, you can open up your download folder and unzip the zip file. If this is done, we can open up this folder and start the exe file. If we start this, this little window pops up. Yeah, the font is not the best at the moment for this one, but it's just a reminder that you should add this con debug to your launch options. So if we have this, we can start the game. Counter-Strike Global Offensive. What this launch option does is everything that is entered to the console by the game is stored in the file. Let's check this moment. Notepad. This is the console file that is logged to, you know. If something happens in the game, like status, whatever, then this will end up in this file. You see? That's the launch option. Nothing else happens here. So if we have this file, this window, we could put this on the second screen, or if anyone else don't have a second screen, I can recommend a tool called Desk Pins. I will put the link to the download for this tool as well in the description. If you start this, you see this little icon down below, and you can enter the pin mode. And if you click on this window, it's pinned. That means if you go inside the game, it will stay in front of the game, you know. So if we enter the game, I'm going to play with bots to demonstrate the tool. You can also change the font size and stuff like this. I've made it really, really easy to use, actually. So we need to select the file and we need to go to the CSGO folder. So if you go to your CSGO path in Steam, there's a folder called CSGO. If you go inside this, we need to select this console.log. If you have done this, it should probably work easily. And we are inside a game. I will move this window so we can see a little bit more. If we send it a message, let's say we say hello in German, it will instantly say hi in your preferred language. Oh, I see if I have a problem right now. Okay, this might be the desk pins actually. Maybe I should look for another solution for the single screen, for the single monitor people. But if you put this on the second screen, it should be fine. Let's say we don't want to listen to English. Let's say we put Russian. I really had really much struggles with Russian because Cyrillic letters are a pain in the ass. Let's say, hello, my friend. Yeah, let's see. It's Russian. If we say we want to see Danish, maybe. Where is it? Dennis. We can also say, oh, hello, my friend. And it will instantly translate it to Danish. And you will see this one. I really don't know why my name is scuffed like this. This must be fixed in the next update. I don't know what it is, actually. But I also added a feature. If you enter echo and say underscore, then there's a language code I will provide in the description as well with different countries. Let's say DE. You could actually write your own message like hello, my friend. And if you press enter, the tool translates it to German in this case, because DE is the country code for German. And it's instantly in my clipboard, so I can just paste it and write something in a language I don't even speak. You know, it's pretty funny. If you have any questions, you can click on this contact me and it opens up my Steam account and you can just add me and send me a message, whatever. It's pretty funny. All right. See you guys and have fun.